BookTube, Chelsea the Reading Outlaw here to do kind of a little mini book haul. I went to a public library book sale over the weekend and I picked up a whole bunch of different things. I went on Sunday, which is bag sale day, which is basically where you go, you pay $6 a bag, and you get as many books as you can fit in that bag. So I got a bunch of really good like cookbooks and a bunch of other things, and among those were a handful of SFF titles that were really exciting. The first thing I got is Who Fears Death by Nnedi Okorafor. This is her first adult novel. It takes place in a post-apocalyptic Africa and deals with Onye, who is a child of rape, but who manages to survive and grow up and become kind of this badass warrior lady who is also magic. So I'm explicitly here for all of those things. It's supposed to be incredibly diverse and incredibly representational. I've really, really enjoyed everything else I've read by Nnedi Okorafor, so I'm really excited to get to this one. Then after that, I got a bunch of mass market paperbacks because they fit in the bag really easy and they're easy to stack. So the first one I picked up was Inferno by Dan Brown. I have all the Dan Brown books. Well, I'm going to slowly be getting all of the Dan Brown books, probably everyone, but The Lost Symbol, the one that was set here in America, because boring. But I really love Dan Brown. I have kind of a weakness for Dan Brown. Like all Dan Brown books, Inferno follows Professor Robert Langdon as he looks at famous works of art, lets us know incredibly random facts about them, and then uses all of that information to stop the end of the world. I'm really looking forward to this. Dan Brown has another book coming out in 2017, so I figured it was about time that I picked up his most recent one and do a reread. My favorite Dan Brown book is definitely The Da Vinci Code, but I've liked almost all of them, like I said, minus The Lost Symbol, which I just thought was really boring. I also picked up Ursula K. Le Guin's The Left Hand of Darkness. This is a book that I've read several times, but have managed to either lose or give out and not receive back my copy of. So I'm always kind of on the lookout for cheap mass market paperbacks. Ursula K. Le Guin is a master of science fiction, and The Left Hand of Darkness is one of her seminal works, so I'm glad to finally have it back in my library. The next two I don't know much about, but I wanted to pick up. The first one is Orson Scott Card's Ender's Shadow. Now, I will not give actual money to Orson Scott Card because he is a garbage human. He uses his money to oppress human rights. But I wanted to read this book because I did not fare very well with the first couple of books after Ender's Game, but I never quite made it to Ender's Shadow. And from what I hear, this is kind of the second strongest book in the whole thing. This is essentially the story of Ender's Game told through the perspective of Bean, who's one of the younger characters in Ender's Game, who I really liked, and I'm here for precocious children, so I will probably pick this up eventually. I was glad to see it because, like I said, I won't buy Orson Scott Card's books because I think he's awful, but I'm all for getting them secondhand. And then lastly is one I really don't know anything about, and that is CJ Cherry's Foreigner. I know that it has aliens in it because it's a novel of first contact, and I know that CJ Cherry is a very well-known female science fiction writer, and I've been really looking forward to having one of her books in my collection. And from what I understand, this is like her most well-known book or one of her most well-known titles. It was well-known enough to me that I was able to recognize it and snatch it off of the science fiction table. So I'm really looking forward to getting to that eventually. We'll probably read some CJ Cherry for the Magical Space Pussycats. I'm not sure when, but I know she's definitely on the list. So yeah, that's everything I've got. Let me know down below which of these you've read, if you have opinions, thoughts. On the Orson Scott Card situation or concerns, how do you separate an author's life from their works? All things I'm interested in. As always, you can find me on all my social media in the down bar. I'm always here to talk books with you, lovely people. Until next time, take care of yourselves, take care of each other, and happy reading.